to speak at this conference, which is very tired of it, and the problem is formulated in a very accurate way. But for me to speak at this conference is very strange, doubly strange. Well, first, because I was an expert for a long time. I was working for the Free Market Institute for more than 15 years, and I joined the government 4 years ago. And I'm Minister of Justice, so of course, speaking about reforms in the justice system and about particular savings in the justice system would be more suitable for me than speaking in general. But of course, when we go to details, if you learn about cutting costs and efficiency in the justice system. Actually, just to clarify a little bit the situation, I must say thanks to Katana, who described that Lithuania is not a success story at all. In describing how efficient we were in cutting expenditure. Of course, on the other hand, I must say that we were a little bit more efficient than the majority of governments over the Europe, and when starting the trend of cutting expenditure, I still remember 4 years ago when we were fooled by majority of experts and other governments who were saying that we have to boost the economy now, we have to spend more, and cutting expenditure is nonsense. Unfortunately, with new elections in some countries, especially in Britain and so on, this new trend of necessity of cutting came on the stage and still preserving, which I think is good. The situation we inherited 4 years ago was specifically bad in Lithuania. Katana already presented something, but I just want to add. We had economic growth for 5 years, for several years, even double-digit growth. Still, we always had budget deficit in Lithuania at least of 3% of GDP, with no, of course, savings, no reserve funds, nothing. Actually, in the year 2008, election year, previous government managed to increase of its obligation by a very visible amount, I think several billion liters, several percent of GDP. For example, social security pensions were increased by 62% in 2008. When everybody was already talking about the crisis, 62%. And of course, it became a law. So this decreasing the future plan spending was also a factual decreasing of just increased pensions. Again, the maternity or paternity benefits were increased by several times, and I think they became twice as good for a parent or mother in comparison to second best state for maternity or paternity. So you just can imagine how generous the government was. And all in all, when we speak about the end of 2008, we had 3% deficit from previous years. No, of course, capital, no savings. And this 3% deficit was at the times when we still had about, as I remember, about 5% of GDP growth. Next year we had GDP decline of almost 20%, almost 20%, and of course out of that, 5% of GDP was direct loss to state budget. So this is a need for cut. And again, several percent of GDP we had this just enacted laws which provided promised new benefits to pensioners, to social security, to anyone. So all in all, we had about the goal of about 10% of GDP with the question, additional goal, to the 3% of GDP before, an additional 10% of GDP, I'm speaking in very rough numbers, and it was the question how to fill that. I must say that at the beginning, it was a huge political debate inside the coalition government. I was representing this more radical, classical liberal party. Others were like center-right, conservative parties. And so we agreed on the formula that all this consolidation will come as this. Two-thirds will be saving, cutting costs, and one-third will be increasing the taxation, mainly in the area, and then first I would say that it was we got a mandate of reducing all the tax breaks, especially on VAT, which was essential part. Unfortunately, the other part, this night tax reform, was very sad story. It was a big mistake, I think, of our government, and please do not repeat it, neither during night day or night time or during daytime. It doesn't matter which time of the day you enact this loss. But this is the situation. So if you show the outline of my presentation, so this is as always. Green is right, what we shall do. Yellow is we have to think about it, sometimes good, sometimes bad, and red one is of course bad one. But this is the logical framework of what government may do when the problem of cutting expenditure or filling the gap, financial gap, does exist. When you have more obligations than financial resources during the year, you have a problem. You have to cut the deficit somehow. Or you have to finance deficit, to put it in broader term. And there are four options in general. To earn more, to use savings from previous years, or to privatize, which is in fact also savings as well, in just in another form, to borrow money or to cut spending. Just going to the yellow ones, I think using savings is of course a good alternative, and Bulgaria and Estonia had this opportunity because they had made decisions to have some savings during good times. And this is exactly when it was a question about what examples to follow. These are examples to follow. Because afterwards, when you made series of stupid decisions, then of course it's very difficult to make an advice what to do now. You had to do make different steps 2 years ago. That's advice. And that's their sense. But using savings is again very dangerous because again, using savings means that you do not reflect to the factual situation. And I know that it's very popular among ancient economists, this savings and anti-cyclical budget reforms, including all those constitutional provisions that are encouraged by European Union and so on. But actually, I don't believe that you have to encourage spending during the bad times. In fact, using savings is very often associated with this encouraging expenditure and encouraging and boosting economy during bad times. Because bad times are exactly the problem of former boost in economy. So you have to save anyway, even if you have kind of below. To borrow, it might be a good opportunity. Again, to use savings, I would say that the difference between a national person or a company or a state is not as big. Now, if you as a person, if your salary is suddenly decreased and you have lots of obligation, you have exactly the same options. And actually, to use savings is an option, but you have to have in mind that this is not long-term strategy. Using savings is actually losing savings. You are becoming more vulnerable and so on and so on. To borrow. Of course, it's an option. You may call SMS credit or whatever company which provides quick credit and then finance your obligations. That is possible. And maybe that is necessary under certain conditions, under very certain conditions. Maybe borrowing is also not as bad a deal if you have a clear plan how it will help to restructure certain areas of economy. For example, you will get rid of pay-as-you-go pensions and you will go to private pension. Maybe that is good. But the main message is you have to be very careful about borrowing. And at the end, if you are in a very bad situation, you don't have opportunity to borrow. That's the essence. Or the only possibility is to call a quick credit company, SMS crediting, and then get a quick credit. And then, of course, to be lost in a year or two. And for example, in Finland, the biggest increase of public expenditure is increase for the credit, the interest rate for the credit we've got. So this is not a good opportunity and not an available opportunity in many cases, including in some countries as we saw during those 3 or 4 years. To earn more, if you are a physical person, if you are a person. Earning more is meaning working more or working more efficiently. So both opportunities are very good. If you are a government, you start to think a little bit differently somehow. And suddenly you have three options, raising taxes, printing money, or freeing economic activity. Raising taxes, again, Katana have illustrated that this is not a very good option because, in fact, you are just putting the problem out of the shoulders of the government, on the shoulders of economy, of people, And in fact, what happens, you are shrinking your tax base, and it will be, in the long run, it will be not beneficial even for the government, not speaking about moral aspects of this of the solution. So I think that even not speaking about the Laffer curve, either you're on left side or right side, even not speaking about this, I think this is not an option. Again, printing money. Some governments which do not have current support arrangement or are not in Eurozone, they're using this opportunity. Of course, it's not a very simplistic printing money, as we know. Printing money is actually boosting economy through cheap credit and so on and so on. But we saw that all countries which had opportunity were using this to some extent. US, UK, European Union and such. Hungary, why it has a budget surplus. It's very clear. Even Poland was using this opportunity. So this is also opportunity, but again, this is not a good opportunity because it is attempt to boost economy in the times when the economy have to restructure. Because exactly as we know, what is crisis? Crisis is the result of former artificial boom in economy, which was caused by a flow of cheap additional money into the economy. That is always the same. So just putting another inflow of money is not the solution. Actually, I remember before being a minister in 2008, I was provided an article from Lithuanian Business Daily with the title, "Have Americans Got Crazy?" About printing machine, about the new pouring more and more money into the economy. They refused to take this title. They thought that it's quite sound economic policy. But in fact, what we see, it simply doesn't work. Because this was tried before the crisis. And crisis happened despite this step, despite the huge inflow of new money, which was in 2007 and 2008. Now we're using the same medicine, it will not work, I must say. To free economic activities. Again, it has no direct relation to fiscal policies, but it is a very good time to rethink your economic policies in general. Because when you look around, you will suddenly find out that to establish a company is not as easy as you would like, to start a new business is not as easy as you would like, all kind of bureaucracies are attacking new businesses and old businesses as well, more fiercely than is advisable, and so on, and so on, and so on. And I think that bad times for economy is very good times to reduce regulation and to create better business environment. Because this is the only solution, actually. Because earning more for government means actually allowing to earn more for citizens, allowing to work more, I mean, more flexible working hours, and allowing to work in more efficient way, actually reducing regulation, in reducing the rigid patterns how you have to work. So this is very very green and the most green part of all the solutions, I would say. Even though it doesn't look like a solution to fiscal problems, but in fact it is a solution. And when, for example, compare raising taxes and printing the economy, I must say that the worst thing about Lithuania's resistance at the end of 2008 was not exactly just increase in taxation. Because, again, not like in the Czech Republic, we had also some decrease in taxation, so some decisions were made to decrease, for example, personal income tax. But the problem was that it was, again, it was presented in that way, in addition to the bad decisions that, you know, thousands of entrepreneurs, they got a message that we don't like you. This was the message how they got it. If you can imagine a country of a Slovakian size, of Lithuanian size, how many entrepreneurial citizens you'd have? Like 30,000? 60,000? How much? It's difficult to guess. But can you imagine if you would take out the willingness to be in economic activities? I mean, I'm fed up with this. No, I will not try anymore. I'm good with what I have. I will not do this anymore. If you would like take out this entrepreneurial spirit out from like 10% of this 60,000%, this is something what will have a real cause in the economy. And on the contrary, freeing economic activities on all those signals having an opposite effect. And again, I'm happy to say that, for example, taking 9 months this year, we have 35% more enterprises established in comparison to last year in Lithuania. And last year was 10% more than the year before. I hope that this is related to the activities of the government, where we were very much focused on pre-economic activities, especially regulation, how all inspections they act and all other things. So I think this is important. And then cutting spending. Again, Cardano was already showing the graph about two options actually cutting spendings. Either you cut horizontally or vertically and systemically. Horizontally means either on even percentage you take out of every structure, or you have some proportional approach. But this is not, of course, not very good because it may reduce the quality of the service, of public service, which is essential and needed. But the problem is that sometimes you don't have an opportunity because simply you are not prepared. And if the crisis rushes on you immediately, and that was exactly the situation we had, so the problem is that you don't have other option. So, okay, you may do this on horizontal level. Another thing, what I think, why it is okay to cut it on horizontal level is that you may create permanent pressure on public service to be more efficient. I think it's very good to create some formula about like cutting expenditure by 5% on any program or on any institution by creating an additional headache for those who are responsible for the program to think how to produce it in a more efficient way. And in fact, there are lots of ways to do this. I'm not going into details of how you may do this on the area of one another ministry, but there are lots of these ways. Just one simple example. For example, you know, how much the telephone communication does cost. Because of untransparent public procurement procedures, it costed a lot 4 years ago. Now it costs 20 times less. And it was achieved in the course of 1 year, not in the course of 4 years. Before, it was typical to cost about 10 euro cents per minute for public service. Now it is, how much is it like? About 1 euro cent, sometimes 5 euro cents, or so. But in general, it is typical that 20 times less. So. And other areas are of similar success. And the last thing, raising efficiency and privatizing particular sectors. This is most important, I think, because again, when you look to sectors, some are very costly, some are not. And if you look at costly sectors, that's in all countries. It's social security, it's pension, social security pensions, it's education, it's healthcare, it's security, and it's national defense. These are the most costly sectors everywhere. And especially in social security, social security pensions, and healthcare and education, I think in all of these areas we've got very serious solutions how to go for privatizing or for being more efficient. In fact, the problem for Lithuania was that there were three areas which had budget growth during those 4 years. One is interest rate on non-credits we were taking. That's understandable because we were borrowing too much. Another was social security. It was increasing a lot with no real reform of actually encouraging people to work. That was a real problem. And the third one, which was also understandable, and reflects maybe the words of French ambassador, because we were more efficient in actually acquiring EU funds, actually most efficient during the last several years. So it means that co-financing for European funding was again the area of increasing budgetary spending, which in fact was good and bad. Bad because subsidiarity of the EU funding means that you have to spend this money not on the needs which are most necessary for you, but on the needs which are of secondary or third necessity. So of course, this inflow of money helped us, but in a way it also distorted the market and distorted us from spending on the most needed areas. So this is the map, how to behave for politicians. I was assured that this is a possible approach. We've tried it, and I would advise to follow this approach to any politician, including myself, after this election, which I come in on Sunday. Thank you.